getting cold here in the northern parts of Italy, of Vercelli. It is the 21st of January and the transfer window is open. There's happened a lot of stuff for all other teams than Pro Vercelli. Now welcome to the Hunt for the Scudetto episode 7. Let me show how it's going in the world of Pro Vercelli since last time, where we beat Regina 4-0. We played after that game against Virtus Franciavia, and Alex did secure the victory with one goal on penalty. After that, we played Biscaglie, we lost a point, but we got a goal from Emanuele Rovini. Then we beat Fondi 2-0, goals from Germano and Rovini on penalty again. Let's take a look at Umberto Germano's goal. Marmorella with a throw-in. Germano is there. Vives Castiglia back to Germano, who just hits it the first time. Another brilliant goal from our midfielders. Then we beat Catania 2-1, goal from Canute and our target man Gianmario Comi. We had a couple of chances, as you can see, but let's take a look at the Mamadou Canute goal. He is playing magnificent in the moment. Here is Rovini, who had played instead of Alex, who's been out with an injury. Marmorello with the ball, crossing it from Comi, flicks it on to Rovini, and Canute just picks it up, scores the goal. We win 2-1 against Catania. For today, we will play against Juve Stabia away and Casertana at home. Though those two teams are both top six teams, and as we can see, Juve Stabia, they haven't lost a game for how long? 10 games Juve Stabia has remained unbeaten. That will change today. As we see, we are of course in the first position. Only one loss, 51 points, halfway through the season. Tanana has fallen off, they can't follow us anymore. So let's just get that promotion to the Serie B, and we need to beat these two top six teams. This is the team for today. As we know them, it is the strongest. We have no injuries to our starters today. Although Andrea Pignamonti is returning from his injury, he will be back soon. And Comi, he's been doing great in the meanwhile. Alex is working his way back from injury. And of course it's just been... the winter transfer window, so we had a break on almost a month here in the Serie C. And as I said, it's just getting colder and colder, but we are now ready to pick up the ball and play some games once again. Here we are, traveled the long way to Juve Stabia. Here they have Daniele Paponi, former Parma player, I remember him. Matute, Mastai, Crialese, Mazzorati, Lino Mazzorati. Yeah, unbeaten for 10 games. Here we go with the kickoff, Juve Stabia Stadium. We are the visitors from Pro Vercelli, number one in the league we are, and number six for Juve Stabia, or was it five? Here we are, Calabria and Murgia, Germano, it is the midfield at the moment, Castiglia, of course, he's still part of the rotation, doing so great, so we will switch up the midfielders from time to time. Here is Paponi, scored a legendary goal for Parma, from way back. He is still in the Italian league system. Mastai finds Sorrentino. First big chance, and he is sneaky. 40 seconds into the first half, and Juve Stabia shows us why they're unbeaten at the moment. Not good enough from our defense, not good enough from Pigliacelli in goal. So let's get out and make a difference. Alex with a cross for Comi. Can't get to it this time. Vives, he is slow, so he can be in that run. There he comes, Vives, with a clean tackle. Great stuff. It doesn't matter, you're slow, he'll get there. And now we set it up again. Germano and Murgia. Goes through our midfield, of course. Canute, he is so hot at the moment. Running down the right winger, crossing it for Comi. The target man gets to it. But Juve Stabia is able to clear this time. Murgia tries again. Germano finds Comi. Unselfishly, he plays it for Alex. A great finish, a good save for the Juve Stabia goalkeeper. Juve Stabia with the goal kick, Branduani. Paponi flicks it on, let's get to that ball, Bergamelli. Finds Germano, Murgia once again, this time for Alex. He's all alone over there. Back to Germano, Murgia. What can we do here? Finding Canucci. Can he get for a cross? He can. Comey almost gets to it. Murgia for Alex. Another shot. This time Branduani holds on to the ball. Throw in from Calabria. Murgia. Germano. Is there room for a shot? There is. Another goal kick from Branduani. Once again, he tries to find Paponi, but Mamarella stops him. Germano for Murgia. Great pass for Canucci. Here we go. Can we find Comey this time? We can, and he flicks it on for Alex. That is why you're the target man, Comey. Great assist from him, and Alex won't disappoint. We're back 1-1. And look at this. It's all starting with Canucci. He is playing fantastic at the moment. Going for another cross, this time early. Quite early though, Comey gets to it, flicks it on, and Alex hits it for 1-1. Great stuff. Here we are again, Calabria for Vives. And Canucci, run with the ball, lots of space. Plays it into the midfield, Comey gets it. Finding Alex, then runs back to the box. But there comes Canucci from the other side. Great chance, good setup. Corner kick, this time is Canucci. Vives picks it up. Hits it in for Comey, what a header. This guy, he's hot at the moment. While Pinamonti is out, Comey with the assist and now with the goal. Great cross from Vives. It comes from the corner kick. Juve Stabia clears it. Vives picks it up. And what a great pass. Finding Comey in the back of the box. And halftime coming up, and we are up 2-1. Free kick from Murgia. It is a goal, 3-1, just before halftime. It's been some games since Murgia has been scoring. I think this was his second goal from free kick. Great finish from Murgia. And it looks fine up to halftime. 3-1. Second half is coming up. We have a substitution for Juve Stabia. Out goes Paponi. And we must say we are strongly back from the winter break. Almost a month we haven't played football in a competitive match. Free kick. It is Vives. And it's Bagamelli. Finding Murgia, big chance again. Will this be the first loss for Juve Stabia in 10 games? It surely looks like it. We cement our first position in this league once again. We are ready to move up to the Serie B, but there is a lot of games to be played still. Now, halfway through the season with the win 3-1 against Juve Stabia, our unbeaten run now is up to 13 matches in a row. No one can touch us. No one can touch us in this league, for sure. Now, the transfer window will shut down in a couple of days and we haven't taken part at all in it. Our finances is very, very struggling at the moment. I don't bother about it. It will change when we move up the leagues. But we, of course, will have some problems signing players later on if we can change it. Hopefully, we can keep some of the players we have when we move up to the Serie B. I say that because I'm pretty sure we'll move up when the season has ended. And now it's Casertana in fifth position. We're having to play at the Silvio Piola, our home field. And coming up to this game, this message ticks in. Pro Vercelli set the record points haul. We are about to break an old record. Bianca Casace sit on 54 points, and with a new Pro Vercelli season record, now will with Now, well within their sights, all eyes will be on them. They're seeking a place in the history books. The existing record by comparison is 61 points. We are very close to break this, and we will do in this season, no doubt about it. Now, I think we'll do only one change for this next game. Luca Castiglia, it is his time to go in and play. The rotation in midfield, as always. And as you can hear, the sound behind me, it is raining, it is windy, it is cold here in northern Italy. But we'll try to go and catch this win anyways. I just keep on expecting the wins. And here we are, Comi with the kickoff, Vives for Mamarella. A lot of our players is really peaking at the moment, playing magnificently. As I said, it's really, really windy and raining outside, and I'm living. Here is a beautiful goal from Vives, what a goal! I'm living in this old hotel. I got a manager hotel room for me, and it's actually raining through the roof. But who cares? Look at this goal. From a throw in from Calabria, it is playing with Morgi and Canoche. Vives, and it's a first time shot. It's another long shot goal from our midfielders. And Vives, he is the one who scored the least goals, but he still can do it at 37. Let's hope it won't rain in anymore. It looks a little bit better right now. Half an hour into the game, it's a free kick, of course, from Mamarella. Who will he find? He finds Castiglia this time with a header. Beautiful goal. And it's once again our midfielders. Beautiful stuff. An assist for Carlo Mamarella. He just knows how to find them in there. And it's Castiglia with lots of room scoring this goal for 2-0 against Casertana. Castiglia with the ball, the goal scorer. Finding Canoche. He will run faster than the fullback. Cross it in for Comi. He can't get to it, but he can get a penalty kick. Who will shoot that? It looks like the captain. Is it Mamarella? It is Alex, of course, the left winger. And he saved. He missed the shot, the penalty. He got the chance, but missed it. Halftime coming up, and now Alex picked up a knock after missing the penalty. Bad stuff. But it will give an opportunity to Emanuele Rovini from bench. He's been playing great. We cannot underestimate any team. Have to stay focused. Nothing's come easy. But Rovini gets his chance. Alex disappointed today by missing a penalty kick. And now a slight knock, an injury for him. Second half, Casertana. Kicking off. Here they are with a throw-in. Finicio for Romano. Finicio once again. Luis Carriero. Great setup from Casertana. They will score in the first minute of the second half. Goal by Stefano Padovan. Corner kick from Mamarella. Team captain. It ends up with Rui Vives. And Canoche. Must be an offside. Offside, we're playing on. Rovini this time crossing it, and Canoche, he comes in there, of course. 3-1. Canoche is great in the moment. What a season from him. And Rovini backing the assist. Good stuff. Here we see Vives finding Canoche. He was online, crossing it into the box. Bacamelli picks it up. There's some room for Rovini. And look at Canoche on the other side. There you go. Great stuff, guys. 3-1. Much better. And now let's give Pignamonti once again some playing time to gain some match fitness. Instead of Comi, playing as the left forward. It could be cool if you could get a goal, Pignamonti, working your way back from the injury. Now it's actually quite sunny. Maybe, how is rainwater? Not that good. Okay, back to the game. Last highlight of the game. It's nothing. another victory, another 3 points for the team. And we are just securing the first place more and more. Here we are, keeping the run going. We haven't lost for 14 games now. And the Tanana game, that will be the interesting one. It is time for revenge for our team. It's the only team who have beaten us this season. We have one loss, and it was against Tanana. So next time in the Hunt for the Scudetto, it's time for the revenge against Tanana. Let's clear that up, beat them, and keep our run going so we can gain that promotion to the Serie B before that goes too long time. Thank you for tuning in. You guys who follow this series, much love for you. And you other guys, please subscribe and hit the like button. I'm out.